Long strings of these bases make up the instructions for one particular characteristic, like a short-haired dog, a gene. And the code is passed on faithfully to all cells in the body because every time a cell divides, its DNA has to make a complete copy of itself and then divide those two copies precisely equally between the two daughter cells. Now, this is a pretty remarkable feat because it turns out that inside our own cells, our DNA would stretch about 2 meters if it was fully unwound. And all that DNA has to be replicated every time a cell divides. And the structure of DNA provides a big clue as to how this might happen. In fact, James Watson and Francis Crick commented on this when they published the structure of DNA 60 years ago. And coming on now, Charlotte, a curator at the Royal Institution, has something rather special to show us. And this is an original copy of Watson and Crick's paper on the structure of DNA in the journal Nature. And I'm going to read you the last paragraph because this is my favourite bit. "It's not escaped our notice," they said, "that the specific pairing we have postulated immediately suggests a possible copying mechanism for the genetic material." Thank you, Charlotte. Well, shall we see what they meant with the help of Infinity Elite? Our acrobats are colour-coded according to which nucleotide they represent. And they're going to form a human DNA strand. Okay, so they're going to obey the rules of base pairing. G and C at the bottom pairing together, so holding hands. And then T and A pairing together, so holding hands. And at the top, G and C holding together, pairing hands. So we've got a strand of DNA made up of 3 bases on each side. Now, this molecule is going to replicate. So the bonds will break. And it's a bit like the DNA molecule unzipping. And then going to turn. And new nucleotides are going to come in. And they're going to bond with their partner in the way that the bases would. So again, G pairing with C, A pairing with T, G pairing with C at the top. They've formed their bonds. And now we can see we've made 2 DNA strands, 2 DNA molecules, absolutely original to the first molecule. Okay. Thank you very much. Please come down now.